think things could have been handled better, and so these are certainly learning experiences for us as we move forward. I think we need to build a stronger relationship working with the leaders team in caucus.
Those were, frankly, some of the kinder words that Charlie Angus had for NDP leader Jagmeet Singh this week. A hope for more FaceTime, maybe a better relationship. Singh drove a bit of a wedge between himself and his caucus by punishing veteran MP David Christofferson for voting with the Conservatives on a controversial summer jobs motion in the House. Singh took Christofferson off a parliamentary committee, then changed his mind and put him back on it. But how much damage has already been done? No better group to ask that question. And at issue. Marie Vestel is in Ottawa with me tonight. So is Paul Wells. And Chantal Hébert is, of course, in Montreal. Good to see everybody. Okay, this was a strange one because I wasn't expecting discipline to happen so quickly. And I think the way that Jagmeet Singh handled it was a little questionable. Chantal, what should we take from this?
That becoming federal leader is a steep learning curve, that becoming a federal politician is a steep learning curve, that the combination of the two of them for a seatless leader is turning out to be quite a challenge. This is not the first time that Jagmeet Singh is forced by caucus to correct his course. It's the third that we know about. Bilingualism for Supreme Court justices, remember, he mused about maybe... In the case of Indigenous Canadians, we could drop that. It's been a long-standing cause of the NDP that Supreme Court justices should be able to hear arguments in both languages. Then last week, correcting the course on attending events where there are Sikh activists promoting violence to achieve their means. And then this, which I think was the more serious one because it went straight to caucus unity and the blood was spilt in public.
And did he have a choice, Paul? Was there any other option here than to put Mr. Christofferson back into his place?
I'm given to understand that the plan was always to put Mr. Christofferson back after a while. This was essentially a stint in the penalty box. It was substantially foreshortened after Charlie Angus criticized the leader publicly. It's interesting. There's kind of a pendulum that swings in party leadership from one style of leadership to another, from the sometimes lackadaisical Jean Chrétien to the hyperactive Paul Martin. Many years ago. Remember that Jagmeet Singh is the leader because the party was sick of Tom Mulcair, who was a master of parliamentary procedure but seemed sometimes to be too much a creature of the House of Commons and unable to reach outside it. Now they've got a leader who sometimes seems unable to reach inside it and connect to the caucus, and he's paying the price for that.
And I wonder how much is due to that, Marie, the fact that he doesn't have a seat, he isn't around a whole lot. I don't see him around a whole lot. No. How much does that have to do with his connections with caucus and sort of getting a read of the room?
Well, I think it has a whole lot to do with it. I think the Christofferson issue translated both of the problems that Chantal alluded to. First off, that he doesn't necessarily know the nuance of federal policy, because in this case, David Christofferson didn't vote with the Conservatives on this motion because he suddenly was not pro-choice anymore. He said he remained pro-choice, which is the NDP's policy, but he felt that the Liberals' change to the attestation for summer jobs grants applications was too restrictive. It didn't let people have the freedom to disagree with the law, even if they agreed to respect it, just to personally disagree with it. And so I think it showed that he didn't grasp the nuance of this thing that has been discussed in the House of Commons for months now. But it also translated the other problem with him not being in Ottawa more than what I think is a few hours a week, because he didn't feel, first off, that David Christofferson felt this very deeply enough to vote against his party, but also that from what we've heard, he wasn't the only one. There were other MPs who had the same malaise with voting against the Conservative motion for the same reasons that David Christofferson did.
You seem to suggest, though, in a column this week, Paul, that this is not, you know, fatal, that no one needs to panic yet.
Well, I suggested the NDP had better not panic in the sense that they're stuck with this leader until the next election. Or trying to replace him would be would cause its own set of problems. If getting rid of Tom Mulcair was a mistake, and different people can reach different conclusions, I think it was a huge mistake. Getting rid of Jagmeet Singh as leader would compound the error and give the impression that the NDP has no idea what it wants to do. This party has to learn to work together. Clearly, the leader has to get to know the caucus. there should be some sort of formal committee system which includes veteran members of caucus working with the leader on the daily and weekly agendas. But also the caucus is going to have to learn to get to know the leader. I think an off-site retreat like you do in a troubled workplace would not be a bad idea. You know, like trust exercises, falling
like,
into each other's
like
arms and stuff like
something.
That.
Yeah, that's good.
Yes, but sometimes I don't disagree with any of that, although I think it's a bit charitable on Paul's part. There are times when provincial politicians do not actually managed to make that transition. Yeah. I'll name two of them, Stockwell Day and Martin Ouellet. And what they have in common with Mr. Singh is that they were sitting members of provincial assemblies, that they were elected with the help of a push for a very different message, and then they could not make it work with caucus, and they disappeared.
Okay, and that's a warning to Jagmeet Singh that you shouldn't probably ignore the tensions with your caucus too long because she lost 7 of her 10 MPs.
Yeah, although she's still there for whatever reason.